I'm Luke Laffin, and I'm a cardiologist at the Cleveland Clinic. Today, we're going to speak about hypertension, also known as high blood pressure. Oftentimes, patients ask me, what is high blood pressure? And we tend to use the terms hypertension and high blood pressure synonymously, although they're not necessarily the same thing. Anyone can have a single isolated episode of higher blood pressure, but hypertension is chronically elevated blood pressures that increase our risk for things like strokes, heart attacks, heart failure, and kidney disease. And depending on the guideline that you're using, typically what we say hypertension is blood pressures greater than 130 over 80 millimeters of mercury. There's many reasons why blood pressure can be elevated, but the biggest factors that ultimately lead to chronically elevated blood pressures and hypertension include getting older. Unfortunately, stiffening of the large arteries in the body ultimately can result in higher blood pressures. And then certain dietary factors like excess sodium or salt intake can also play a role. Extra weight, so obesity, particularly midline obesity, so that beer belly, so to speak, that can definitely contribute to high blood pressures. And then there's clearly genetic predisposition in certain individuals as well. If your family members had blood pressure issues early in life, you're more likely to develop them as you get older. A question I'm often asked is, how do I know if I have high blood pressure? What am I going to feel like? The answer is the vast majority of people have no idea that they have high blood pressure. And that's why they call it the silent killer, hypertension. So it's really important to get it checked regularly. Now, if blood pressure elevates all of a sudden, erratically for whatever reason, you may notice that you have a headache, you feel more anxious, but that is the minority of individuals. The vast majority of people do not know that they have high blood pressure. Anxiety and stress can definitely cause elevations in blood pressure. Now, do these cause sustained elevations in blood pressure? Not necessarily. It's typically their impact on some of the lifestyle things that can cause sustained elevations in blood pressure. So if job is stressful, home life is stressful, you're not going to make the right dietary choices. You're not going to be sleeping well. You're going to consume excessive alcohol. You may put on some weight. All of that will ultimately raise blood pressure as well. So anxiety and stress unto itself will not necessarily elevate blood pressure long term unless it's having an impact on those lifestyle factors like dietary indiscretion, etc. Certain foods can definitely contribute to elevations in blood pressure. Far and away, the most common culprit for increasing blood pressure are foods that are high in sodium. Sodium is a really quick and easy fix that most people can make to their diet to try and lower their blood pressures as much as possible. Instituting a low sodium diet typically is worth about 1 to 2 blood pressure medicines in the average individual. And it's very important that if you're taking blood pressure medicines to focus on being on a low sodium diet as well. Oftentimes I'm asked, are there natural ways to lower blood pressure or lifestyle interventions that can be done? And there definitely can. And it doesn't necessarily mean you don't need medicines, but lifestyle interventions are about 70% of blood pressure management. Medications are only about 30% or so. And the big ones that we think about are eating a healthy diet, okay, including a low sodium diet, losing weight and getting to really an ideal body weight, exercising regularly, and being mindful of not consuming excess alcohol. Those are the best interventions that you can do to ultimately lower blood pressure. Individuals with elevated blood pressure or individuals with a new diagnosis of hypertension or those that maybe have had hypertension for a while, but it just seems to be creeping up and not under as good a control as they'd like, they should definitely speak with their physician about making adjustments to their medication regimen or really starting to focus on some of those lifestyle factors, losing weight, getting more active, watching sodium. Those are really the next best steps that need to be taken to better control blood pressure. Remember, controlling blood pressure is a long-term issue to hopefully decrease your risk of strokes, heart attacks, heart failure, and kidney disease.